fermentation really kind of fit the bill, combined a little bit of everything I love. You know, it's an art and a science.
Because you can make so many different things out of four very simple ingredients.
Our students play a very important role in the work that we do.
Not only just in the brewing side of things, but just conducting scientific research.
There's guys out there throwing valves by hand to get this product out the door. They're very proud of it. They drink it. They live the lifestyle. They actually get involved in the lifestyle.
It seemed like a smart choice to me to get into brewing and go back to school. I loved science in high school and growing up, and this is a way for me to have that connection of hands-on mechanical work plus science. Working out here in the lab has given me more experience than anything else. Like, if I hadn't had my experience at the Pelican or here, I don't think I would be prepared at all to go out into the real world.
You know, definitely having that science background sets you apart. There's a lot of processes that it's a lot more hands-on, but the way that the industry is moving, especially in brewing at least, like, you know, that's not enough to have to be like an avid home brewer or to just have worked part-time at a brewery before. You know, having that science background is really important now. I visited other schools too, and I think the real difference here is, even as an undergrad, I mean, the faculty and the staff are willing to let you use the equipment, you know, to help you learn. And that's not something that happens everywhere, I know.
The type of research that we do here at the graduate level, anyways, in the brewing science program, deals a lot with either the industry side, so it's chemical and product formulation, helping brewers or having brewers come in and brew new styles of beer on our equipment, helping them with product formulation. Also, we look at the raw ingredient side, particularly hops, barley, and yeast as well. So what I look at is the chemical makeup of hops, the aroma compounds in hops, and how that profile affects the way they smell.
So the students are out in the pilot brewery as a group, brewing at least once a month, if not twice a month. They'll bring guest brewers in from around the Northwest. So they do more than just study it. They're like living it and creating beers and experimenting. Around the world, yeah, we're definitely on the map. Our students are beginning to explore opportunities around the world. We send students to Germany routinely to study there and to work there. And yeah, people know that OSU is a place to find brewing students.
The more we have this interaction between the breweries and Oregon State, I think the more it's going to be a good experience for everybody. We're the cradle of craft brewing, really. I mean, generally between Oregon and Colorado, I mean, those are the two states that really got the craft brew revolution going. Our brewers are 75 barrels at a time, so we're talking about 150 kegs worth of beer. If we mess it up, then we got 150 kegs worth of beer that we have to put down the drain. It's going to be pretty expensive. So what we generally do is we will go down to Oregon State, we'll take our ingredients down there with us, and we'll use that pilot brewery to make a small brew. Most of the last several brews that we've brought out actually have been, one time or another, been brewed at Oregon State. I think people are going to continue to innovate beers and come up with new ideas for years to come. I think there's a long ways to go on that. Just the idea of drinking that bland golden liquid is just not enough for people anymore. So.